What's going on everybody, this is Kurt and I'm back with a thrilling new video packed with valuable tips. Prepare to immerse yourself in the amazing world of hyper-realistic automotive rendering. In this tutorial, we will uncover the secret of creating stunning hyper-realistic brake and caliper shaders inside Maya, powered by the incredible Arnold Render. You will master the step-by-step process of setting up your scene, crafting detailed shaders, and tweaking advanced settings for stunning photorealism. We will explore everything from basic setup to complex imperfections, textures, techniques. Whether you are a beginner looking to enhance your skills or a seasoned pro aiming to refine your shader artistry, this tutorial is tailor-made for you. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea, and let's roll the intro! Before we dive into the heart of this video, ask yourself, do you ever dream of crafting 3D cinematic sci-fi worlds? Well, buckle up because I've got something extraordinary for you. Welcome to an unexpected odyssey, episode 1, environment modeling with Maya. This full course is your gateway to mastering the art of modeling and designing immersive environments. I will be sharing with you how to plan and organize personal projects, keep motivation, and be efficient in tackling such a large environment scene. Discover a modeling workflow that thrives on precision, channeling attention towards shapes, forms, and harmonious proportions. Uncover ingenious kitbashing and modular asset strategies that infuse life into your scenes. Let's turn your dreams into stunning reality. The adventure begins now, and you can join the journey over at primalvfx.com. Alright guys, to start this project, we need a good model. I've discovered this brake and caliper model made by Clément Feuillet. This is really well made and at high quality level. Also, as you can see, all the parts are separated. It's quite complete and ready to go. So we'll start by purchasing and downloading this model for our tutorial. Now, here we are in Maya. Let's open the file. There, here it is. You can see that the model is of very high quality indeed. The topology of the mesh is excellent. Thank you, Clément, for that. I have also gathered some references of caliper and brake to get a direction of what to do regarding the materials and surface imperfections and all the details we'll need to create. Okay, let's get things started. Let's switch to my shading workspace mode to optimize my viewport. First off, we want to subdivide our objects into multiple shaders as needed. This phase is called data preparation of the model, so we need to create several AI standard surface shaders and delete their respective surface engines for now. Rename the first shader to metal red and change its base color to red. Next, assign it to the caliper. Rename the second shader to logo and assign it to Brembo mesh. Now, do the same for the brake disc shader. Next, the metal black for the inner part of the disc. And last, the chrome material. Nice! Let's create another material and rename it rubber. Let's select the parts and assign it to the geos. Change the base color to a dark tone. Assign the remaining pieces without a correct shader. Nice! We have finished the first part, which was data prep. Let's clean the unused nodes. Done! Quick notice here, if I open the outliner, you can see that everything is clean and tidy. It's important to have everything well organized if you work in production with a team. So it's good to get into this habit early on. We can now move on to the next step. Let's open the lookdev file that I have already prepared in advance. If we look a moment to the setup of the scene, it's pretty basic. We've got an HDRI, a top light, rim light, and left light. The one on the left is our key light, and of course a studio backdrop. So let's import our prepared model into the scene. We can now delete the newly created namespace to keep things clean. Drag and drop the mesh group to the main geo one. Let's change the perspective view to the camera view. We can adjust the rotation of the group to make something a bit more interesting. Sweet. Now let's launch the IPR to see what we've got. We can also lower the samples for fast iteration during our lookdev session. Okay, now it's time to get into the tough part and to the most fun section.
Let's begin with the first shader of many, the break disk. As it is a metal surface, increase the metalness value to 1. Lower the base color to a mid gray. Increase the roughness value to 0.35. Let's split the chrome shader into two different shaders. One for the break disk and one for the remaining ports. My bad, I forgot to do it before. Okay, now it's done. We can go back to defining our disk break shader. First, let's create an IRAMP RGB. Change the type to radial. It will drive our anisotropy effects on the metal. So we need to connect the IRAMP RGB output to the specular anisotropy input of the shader. If you don't see the input, click on the shader and then Edit Custom Attribute List. Then click on Specular Anisotropy. Okay, now take the out color error of the ramp node and connect it to the specular anisotropy. Edit the ramp gradient to something like this. After that, play with the slider of the rotation value to get the desired effect. Yeah, something like that. Let's go with a 0.19 value. Now we can add our two main maps to create the material. A normal and a roughness map. Let's add the normal map first. Create a bump 2D node. Connect it like this. Make sure you switch to tangent space normal into the bump map node. Let's configure also the Arnold RG channel correctly to have the right effect. Now we can lower the bump value to 0.2 because right now it's way too strong. Sweet. Then the other map. We can plug it to the base color. Lower the base weight to 0.8. Let's remap it with an AE range. Nice. Connect the AE range to the specular roughness. Let's disconnect the node in the base color. Lower the base color value. Okay. Let's add an AE color correct node and plug it like this. Let's check that in the IPR. Lower the gamma. Pretty nice. Let's increase the gamma to make it pop a bit more. Boom. Now, before to move on to the next shader, remember to clean up the name of the nodes to keep things organized. Now, let's move to the logo shader. This will be a quick one. Let's tweak the value here.
Hey you, I know you're watching my video, and I know you're not subscribed yet. It's literally so easy, just go down there and boom, press subscribe. So like this video, comment and hit the subscribe button. Now back to this sweet shader.
Okay. Next, the rubber material. Also here, a quite simple shader that don't need too much attention. Playing with the base weight, color, specular weight, roughness and IR. Let's call it done. Move on to the next and more interesting material, the chrome one. Let's lower the base color, metalness to 1, roughness to 0.35. Nice. Let's put the anisotropy to 0.5. Now let's add some surface imperfection to give life to this material. Let's take this map from Quixel Megascan. We can add an AE range to remap it as usual and connect the node like this. Let's rename the node, tweaking the value here of the output max and min. Let's add some subtle color in the base and also in the specular. Pretty nice. Let's move to the main piece, the caliper. Lower the specular to 0.8. Roughness to 0.3. Lower also the IR to 1.33. And the base color to a medium red. Now that our base color is created, we now can create first some color variation. Create an AE noise and connect it to the base color. Let's tweak the parameters here. Size and colors. Pick the same red as before and create one color slightly brighter and another one slightly darker. Nice. Let's rename the node. Then duplicate the node 2 times. We will create the bump based on a mix of high frequency and low frequency noises. So connect the first node to the base color to see what we are doing. Tweak the values. Now do the same process for the second node, creating some variations. Now to mix the two nodes, let's create an AE layer RGBA. Plug the low frequency mode to input 1 and high frequency to input 2. And the out color to the base color for the moment. On the AE layer RGBA parameters, in layer 2, change the operation mode to plus. Also lower the mix value in layer 1 by half. Sweet. Now create a bump 2D node and connect it like this. lower the bump depth value to 0.6 and reconnect the color noise node to the base color. Nice. Now it's time to create complexity with metal underneath some chipped damage. Let's take our previously created chrome material. Now to mix the two shaders together, we will use an IE mix shader. Then take the metal red shader output and connect it to the input of shader 1 and connect the chrome shader output to the input of shader 2. Now with the mix weight, we can drive the mix. Let's create a mask to drive that mix. We will use this map. Connect this to the mix shader into the mix input temporary. Let's tweak the scale. Nice. Now create an IE range, then an IE curvature. Let's tweak the value of the IE curvature. Increase the radius. Lower the spread. Then connect the IE range to the IE curvature radius input. Let's tweak the value to have something interesting. Nice. Now, I don't like it too much when the curvature effect is too visible all along the edge of the object. To break that, we will use a noise. Duplicate the previous noise. Create an IE layer RGBA to mix the two things together. Connect it like this to see what we've got. Let's tweak the noise parameters. Now connect the IE range to the input 1 and the noise cutoff to input 2 of the IE layer RGBA node. Change in the IE layer RGBA attribute the layer 2 operation to subtract. Sweet, that's something interesting. As you can see, it really makes a difference and helps break the uniformity of the edges. Lastly, let's add an IE range to boost the output value a bit and make the effect more prominent. Let's rename the nodes. Then, the last step to embellish this material, let's add some dirt. To do so, create another IE mix shader. Connect the nodes like this. Create an IE standard material. Rename it IE dirt. Connect it. Let's make this color green to see better what we are doing. Now we choose to use this map to drive the mix. Again, create an IE range node and an IE ambient occlusion node. Connect it to the mix value of the mix shader. Invert the black and white value. Increase the sample to 8. Decrease the spread. And fall off to 0.2. Nice. Now connect the red channel to the spread input of the IE ambient occlusion node. Let's tweak the tile of the map. Sweet. Let's tweak also the IE range output value. Add another IE range to boost the output value again. And a reverse node as the effect is inverted. Now let's configure the dirt shader correctly. Really nice. Let's rename the nodes. Now the last material, the black metal. Once again, let's configure the base material, tweaking its values. Now we will use this map, which is pretty interesting with some stains. Let's add an IE range and connect it to the node like this. Let's adjust the tiling of the map. And then we can remap it with an IE range a little bit. Let's take our previously created chrome, create an IE mix shader, and connect the nodes like this. Now let's create an IE curvature to drive the mix. Let's tweak its parameters. Okay, nice. Now let's select another map to drive the radius of the IE curvature with its IE range to remap it as usual. Let's boost the contrast a bit. Great. Let's lower the multiply value in the curvature node. Again, I prefer it a bit more subtle. Renaming the nodes now. Now for the last step, let's add some dirt again. So create an IE mix shader and connect it like this. Then, take the IE dirt shader previously created and connect it like this. Now we will use another map to drive the mix as always. Let's take this one and create an IE ambient occlusion node. Connect it like this and tweak its values. Once it's done, connect everything together. Decrease the value of the repeat UV tile. Now in the ambient occlusion node, invert the black and white values. I think we've created a really interesting surface. And boom, the final result. Really, really nice. What do you think, guys? This is a really cool way of doing some realistic brake and caliper shaders.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.